What is up, guys? Welcome back to another follow-up video, and today I'm bringing you the three best glitches currently in the game in Fallout 4, which is the XP glitch, a duplication glitch, and a bottle cap glitch, which all really revolve around the same thing, which is a pretty difficult method to actually get them to work. And I constantly get messages saying that they have patched the glitch, which they haven't yet as of June 12th. They're all currently still working, just a lot of people don't know the actual good techniques to doing it, and in this video I'm going to be going in depth and showing you guys step by step how to do it. Videos of my hand movement and controller movement when I'm doing this, so hopefully you guys can get it down yourselves, because I've pretty much mastered this glitch so far, so I pretty much know all the tricks to it. So if you guys do enjoy this video, make sure to like, subscribe, and let's get right into it. So on my previous glitch videos, mainly being the ones that are the all working glitches series where I show you all the working glitches in Fallout 4, I get a ton of comments saying that these glitches are patched when they're in fact not. They're just somewhat difficult if you have never tried them before. So to do it, just go to your workbench, pick any junk that you want to duplicate, put it in your inventory. It's a lot faster if you just take everything out of your workbench and put it in a separate container. But once you've done that, just go ahead and drop all of your items onto the ground. As you can see, I am duplicating acid. So once you have done that, go into the workshop mode and then hover over your little item. And then it is easier if you go off of it a little bit by moving your cursor up, but it's still highlighted so you can still see it. Now here comes the difficult part. Since I am on PS4, I'm going to be referring to PS4 controls, but if you are on Xbox One, you just kind of convert the buttons. So what you want to do is you want to press square and circle, and after you press square, you want to press circle a minuscule amount of time after you press square. There are three different strategies to this. This is the first one. I'm going to be going the other ones later in the video. Also, I'm going to be doing a video of me in real life of showing you the hand movements of how you should be doing it. So just press square and then circle right after that super fast when you are hovered over the adhesive or whatever scrap you want. Now, once you have done that, it should show up as a screen, such as are you sure you want to scrap this to your workbox? Once you see this, go ahead and just press yes, and there should be a duplicated version of it inside your workbench, so you should have double the amount of what you had before. So as you can see, I'm going over to my workbench, going into transfer stuff, go over to your junk, and then you should see it duplicated from your original amount. I had 178 my first time, now I have 356. So now that you've duplicated it, put it back in your inventory, drop it on the ground, and you should have two of them now. Just go back into your workbench and go into workshop mode and just scrap both of them, and that should get rid of that issue where there's two of them now. And you go back to your junk, there should be just one stack of them now. So the second method to doing this glitch is just dropping the item on the ground, again, going over and hovering over it, and then hold square. This is the one you want to do if you are not used to doing this glitch. Hold square, and then while you're holding square, it's not going to scrap until you do that. Press circle right after you let go of square, and that should be a better way of doing it the first time if you aren't used to doing it, because you can practice your timing without it actually scrapping it into your workbench and having to start all over. And this is the one I recommend fully if you do not know what you're doing yet. And like I said, you'll know you have done it right whenever asked if you are you sure you want to scrap this to your workshop, and that's when you know you've done it right and you'll hear like a little scrapping sound. If it just says it's stored the workbench, it didn't duplicate and you have to redo it again. Now this is the third method and the final method, and this is what I use. I don't know why, I just use it. It just works all the time for me, and I get the glitch to work pretty much every time. So what you want to do is just hover over your item again, and then just start your thumb on the square, and basically just slide it over all of the buttons super fast so it hits circle. But in that time, it also hits X, but that doesn't really matter. And it just seems to, because you're supposed to press it really fast, so whenever I slide it over, it presses it super fast, and it just seems to work for me a lot more often. I've heard a lot of people say this is a harder method, but it's just the one that works for me, and I will be showing it on video later to show you guys, and you can get a better hang of what I'm actually trying to show you. Okay guys, so here's what it looks like in real life, and I'm going to demonstrate the first method, which is where you just press square and then circle fast. Now this is the timing you're going to want to use, and this is how you're going to want to do it. So once you are hovering over your scrap that you want to duplicate, you just press square like this, and then press circle that fast, and it should work. This one I find harder to use in my method, but it's also one I'm not really used to. So here is the second method, which is basically where you hold square and then press circle right after. When you do this one, you want to hold square until you're ready to duplicate the item. It's not going to scrap until you let go, And right after you're done holding square, press circle that fast like that, and it should duplicate. Now, this is the third method, which is the method I use, and this is the one that I get to work most of the time. So this is how you want to do it. You want to hold, or you don't want to hold it. You want to start on the square and just slide your thumb over like that. And that's how I do it. You end up pressing X and sometimes triangle in the process, but it still does duplicate. Those buttons don't do anything. So just slide it over like that, and it should give you the option to store the item in your workbench. Okay, guys, so hopefully that little video representation of how you do it helped you and clears up any like questions you guys might have had. Sorry if the quality wasn't as good as you hoped. I had to record it on my iPhone in portrait mode, so if you can't hear me too well, I'm sorry. So again, hopefully that does clear up any questions you may have had. Now, this is pretty much for all this glitch. We're going to be moving on to the bottle cap glitch, which does require pretty much the same technique. Alright guys, so for this bottle cap glitch, you want to go into workshop mode and then scroll over to the stores option in your workshop. Now, once you have done this, you either want to use the weapons emporium, because that does give you the most, but it is also the expensive. If you can't afford it, just use a cheaper version, but I'm using the one that costs 3,000 bottle caps, which is the fastest one to do. So once you have done that, go ahead and just place down a store anywhere you want to, it doesn't really matter, and then go back out of that little option, and then hover over it so it is outlined in whatever color your Pip-Boy is, and then press square, X, and circle again, however technique you found you liked. Use that one for this, because it is going to matter, because you're using bottle caps for this. If you are worried you are going to mess it up, make a quick save before you do all this so you don't lose any bottle caps if you mess up a few times. But once you press square and circle, you're going to see this little option again. It says store weapons emporium in the workshop. Go ahead and press yes, and that's when you know you've done the glitch right, when it comes up that you still have one to use in your workshop. So it's like where it is hovering around, it has a one. So you're going to place this one down for free, and then once you scrap this and do the duplication glitch at the same time, you're going to be making one for free, but then also selling one for 1,000 bottle caps. So as you can see here, every time you do it, you gain 1,000 bottle caps, which is really nice. And this glitch is just all about timing, so once you get the timing down, you're going to be doing it all the time, and it's super easy once you figure out the thing. As you can see here, I'm just doing it over and over and over again without failing at all. So hopefully you guys do enjoy this glitch. Hopefully you can do it yourself, because it is a very good one. A quick note, you can also do it with these little counter ones. I just find it a little bit harder because they're smaller, and like, I don't know why, I just find them harder. But you can do them the same way that you would do them with normally with all of them, and it is a very good method to use with bottle caps. So now that we have finished this glitch, and hopefully you guys have figured everything out for this and it's working for you, we're going to be moving on to the final glitch, which is a XP glitch, and it is a very, very good XP glitch. It does require DLC though, and that is the robots one. It's only like $5, so if you don't have it, I mean, $5 isn't that much money, so if you don't have it, I have plenty of more XP glitches in plenty of other videos, but this is just the best one currently working in the game. So if you don't have it, I do apologize. Alright guys, for this glitch, it is an XP glitch, and you're going to need the Automatron DLC for the Automatron workbench to actually craft a Automatron robot. So basically what you do, just go to the workbench and then craft yourself a new robot. And once you've made yourself a new robot, just scroll down a torso and click Protectron Torso, and then just buy one that you can unlock. So if your most unlocked one is Mr. Handy like me, do that one. If you can do Sentry, do that one. So as I did mine, I did Mr. Handy, so I equipped it, and then go back and unequip it by selecting Protecton Torso at the top, and it should unequip it, and it should be in your inventory now. Now that you have equipped and unequipped the torso from your new Automatron, go over to your workshop, and then make a cabinet or any type of container next to it to place in a whole bunch of items, because what you're going to be doing is taking all the junk from your workshop that is required to actually build the torso, and then you're going to be putting that inside of the container, so whenever you go to actually craft a another torso, it's not going to let you, because you won't have the correct amount of materials. Once you have taken all your junk and put it inside of a container, just command one of your companions to go stand by the robot workbench. And it doesn't matter who it is, it can be a robot, it can be your dog, it can be whatever you want it to be. So once they are standing by the workshop, just ask them to trade, exit out of the trade, select again, it's going to be delayed, and then select the workbench before it actually goes into the screen where it does to trade with them. And most of you guys probably already know this glitch, but I mean, it is new to a lot of new people. So once you're in this screen, it should really look glitched out like this. Just scroll down to your torso again and click on the torso that you had just unlocked, and you can just keep getting a whole bunch of XP by selecting X and right on the D-pad for PS4. And if you just keep spamming these buttons, it's going to make a really weird sound, and you know you've done it right whenever it sounds like this. So just do this for however long you want to, and then when you're done, just exit the station, and you will find when you exit out of all the screens, there's going to be an XP meter on the side of your screen that is counting up all the XP that you had accumulated over the process of just buying a ton of torsos for your robot for free. So that's basically how you do this glitch. It's actually really simple. It just takes a while to get a hang of. Alright guys, sorry to use old gameplay for that video. My gameplay I got for this video got corrupt of me doing the XP glitch, so I just used an old video. So hopefully, because I feel like I went over that really, really well, and it's not too hard of a glitch, but hopefully you guys do enjoy this video. If you did find it helpful at all, or it helped you do the duplication glitches or stuff like that, make sure to like, subscribe. I do plenty of glitches every day, and we make mod videos, all types of stuff, so if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye. I seen a lot of shit I shouldn't have, but never forgot it though. Brothers on the corner selling crack like it was nada though. Walk inside my kitchen, baking soda all up on the floor. Police banging on the door while gripping the 44. I was just a youngin', but this type of shit I seen before. Y'all see a white boy, but my daddy a negro. Half breed, motherfucker, grip the mic and he.